The foundation for the upcoming Starship era is slowly approaching its zenith. Designed with innovative enhancements that surpass the adjacent Pad A system, this launch pad is purpose-built to accommodate the ambitious goals and daunting challenges of future endeavors. As we look forward to Pad B reaching full operational capacity, let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. The establishment of Pad B marks a significant transformation at Starbase, ushering in what could be called the dual tower era, representing SpaceX Starship iteration of dual launch infrastructure. This launch pad will incorporate several significant enhancements over Pad A, effectively increasing its reliability and efficiency. Its design can be described as consisting of three main components: the launch tower, the orbital launch stand, and the fire trench system. The launch tower will incorporate several significant structural and functional enhancements. The tower will be slightly taller than the current Pad A tower, likely to accommodate the next iteration of Starship version 2. Additionally, the sump mechanism designed to capture and stack Starship will be reduced in length. As stated by Elon Musk, these modifications are intended to streamline complexity and minimize redundancy while maintaining efficacy. The blowpipe mechanism will undergo further refinement. Improvements will be made to the landing rail and pin system to achieve better compatibility with Starship's landing pins, which are relatively smaller and shorter than those used on the Super Heavy. This suggests that Tower B will serve not only as a launch platform, but will also focus on facilitating Starship recovery efforts, thus advancing the prospect of full reusability. Construction of the launch tower has progressed at a noteworthy pace. Following the deconstruction of the obsolete infrastructure and the clearing of the surrounding area, the foundation was erected and assembly of the tower segments began. Notably, this process was completed in just one day. Between July 11th and August 21st, SpaceX leveraged the expertise gained from the construction of Pad A. Following this accelerated assembly, attention shifted to the development of the flame trench system, which resulted in a temporary halt to activities related to the launch tower. It was not until early this year that real progress on the tower began again. By the end of January, the section dedicated to the blowpipe was in the process of being strategically repositioned. The support frame for the blowpipe stack was then built along the tower, providing a foundation for additional installations. Shortly thereafter, the blowpipe rail system was lifted onto the frame, facilitating the installation of the primary arm. Following the formation of the sump system, additional components were inserted, leading to a series of comprehensive testing efforts to ensure structural integrity and operational reliability. This assessment is critical, given that Tower B is anticipated to play a critical role in SpaceX's ultimate goal of capturing and reusing Starship vehicles. Conversely, the orbital launch mount signifies a significantly more revolutionary shift from the current design. In contrast to the hexapodal tripod architecture observed at Pad A, the forthcoming OLM will encompass a box-shaped design constructed from several fortified segments. Its overall design will mirror that of an advanced and enlarged transport stand. A remarkable advancement of this innovative OLM is its mobility, representing a significant enhancement over the static infrastructure of Pad A. The capability to relocate the OLM will facilitate SpaceX's ability to exchange launch mounts as required, thereby permitting maintenance or enhancements without interfering with the overarching launch timetable. This represents a considerable advantage over Pad A, which necessitates on-site refurbishment work, thereby requiring a suspension of launch operations until the repairs are finalized. Presently, the construction of the OLM at the Sanchez site is progressing, as evidenced by images and footage depicting it enveloped in scaffolding and bustling with teams of workers. In contrast to the launch tower, the advancements of the OLM are not consistently chronicled through structured updates. Considering its intricacy, it is anticipated that this will be the last element to be installed at the launch pad. The transition and incorporation into Pad B will probably signify one of the final milestones before the new system becomes operational. Aiding the OLM, the flame trench system will serve as the third and most groundbreaking element, anticipated to enhance both protection and efficiency during Starship launches. As construction progresses, the excitement mounts for the moment when Pad B will reach full operational status, heralding a transformative phase for Starship and bolstering SpaceX ambitions for rapid reusability and frequent launches. The flame trench is a well-established concept within the aerospace sector, having been utilized for decades to accommodate the intense forces produced during rocket launches. In the previous year, SpaceX formally unveiled this system at its extensive testing facility, showcasing its efficacy in diverting heat, pressure, and energy away from both the vehicle and the launch infrastructure. Strategically situated beneath the launch pad, or test stand, the flame trench is meticulously engineered to direct exhaust flow outward, thereby reducing any direct impact on the rocket and its surrounding infrastructure. Moreover, it incorporates a water deluge system that significantly amplifies its efficacy in dissipating heat and pressure, positioning it as a highly viable long-term solution for frequent launches. This design represents a notable advancement compared to the existing water-cooled steel plate system utilized in USET Pad A. The steel plate system, instituted since Flight 2, functions akin to an inverted shower, dispersing water prior to the ignition of the rocket engines. Although it has excelled in alleviating heat and pressure, it possesses significant limitations. The system is continuously subjected to engine thrust, and notwithstanding its cooling mechanism, these steel plates will inevitably undergo considerable wear over time. The discoloration evident in the post-launch images indicates that this system deteriorates with successive use, rendering it an unsuitable solution for a high-frequency launch schedule. SpaceX's strategy to address this challenge involves the installation of an enhanced dual-flame trench system at Pad B. This design comprises two flame buckets, efficiently dividing and channeling the exhaust flow in two distinct directions. By channeling the substantial energy produced by Starship's engines through two pathways, the system effectively alleviates the strain on the launch pad, thereby enhancing its longevity and efficiency. This progress is particularly significant, as upcoming versions of Starship are expected to be more powerful, necessitating a robust infrastructure capable of facilitating frequent launches with minimal refurbishment. Presently, the flame trench system is undergoing construction at the Sanchez site, in conjunction with the development of the new orbital launch mount. The structure is meticulously constructed through the welding of numerous manifolds, thereby establishing the fundamental framework of the dual flame trench system. Nevertheless, prior to the installation of this system, it is essential to complete the foundational work beneath the launch site. In order to facilitate the installation of the flame trench, SpaceX commenced with the excavation of the site, subsequently laying down a foundational layer of concrete to ensure a robust base. Subsequently, steel reinforcement is integrated in anticipation of an additional layer of concrete, which will enhance the structural integrity further. The magnitude of this undertaking is truly considerable. SpaceX has mobilized 350 concrete trucks to the site, highlighting the monumental scale of the foundation's construction. The subsequent pivotal milestone will involve the installation of the flame trench walls. Certain prefabricated elements of this system have already reached Pad B, indicating that the installation phase is imminent. Upon the establishment of the walls, supplementary layers of concrete will be poured to complete the structural framework. At that juncture, the flame buckets will be conveyed and assimilated into the system, signifying the concluding stage prior to operational testing. In addition to the primary launch systems, a number of supplementary systems are concurrently being developed at Pad B. Next to the flame trench location, SpaceX has erected a QD gantry, a robust steel structure comprising a triangular framework. This system will optimize the synergy between the ground support infrastructure and the launch vehicle, thereby augmenting fueling and servicing operations. Concurrently, new tank farms are being constructed, with water tanks consistently arriving on site. These tanks will play a critical role in providing a water sinking system for the fire trench. Once installation is complete, SpaceX is expected to continue digging additional tracks for the purpose of installing piping that will connect the tanks to the launch pad's cooling and suppression systems. The ongoing improvements at Pad B will not only determine Starship's future trajectory at Starbase, but also impact SpaceX's overall infrastructure strategy. Comparable progress is expected at Kennedy Space Center, where the recent dismantling of the LC-39A orbital launch pad has paved the way for the deployment of more advanced systems. These actions demonstrate that SpaceX is strategically preparing for the next generation of launch sites that stretch beyond Texas. An integral marker of SpaceX's long-term aspirations is the ongoing expansion of its Robert Road facility, where construction of a new Star factory in Giga Bay is currently underway. This expansion demonstrates that SpaceX is ready for a substantial increase in launch frequency underscoring the need for highly efficient and rapidly reusable infrastructure. The rapid progress of Pad B, featuring an improved fire trench and an upgraded launch tower reconfigured for the OLM, marks a significant milestone in ushering in a new era for Starship. As these innovations advance, SpaceX is redefining the parameters of launch pad reuse and efficiency, laying the foundation for increased launch frequency and bolder spaceflight ventures. Which of the improvements to Pad B do you find most remarkable? I invite you to share your thoughts in the comments section below. If you appreciate the update, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on SpaceX's latest progress. As Pad B nears its final stages of completion, excitement is building in anticipation of its first operational use. Given the pace of construction, it is anticipated that SpaceX will need at least an additional month to complete the site. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.